So what is the abstract data type tree? Well, it's a hierarchical structure in which you have nodes and edges, and from one node you can have several edges outgoing, two additional subnodes, and all starts from one common root, like in a real tree. But you could imagine that the tree here, you know, it's kind of swapped. So this is kind of the leaves on the bottom, and the root is here on top. Okay, so we see we have here a couple of edges. So this is a specific tree where we have only one or two edges from each node. And at last level, we have leaves. A leaf is characterized as a node that has no further descendant. And on the bottom, you have several of those fancy leaves. To a node that has additional children, we often say internal node as well. So depending on the type of tree you have, you typically have up to n children, where n is defined. And a child is connected when you go from a child to exactly one parent. So you will find that there is exactly one path from one leaf to the root, and this path is unique. Okay, so there is no connection, for example, on this level again, and another connection here. So there's always one way from a leaf to the root. So what's the root node? The root node is a starting node without a parent. A leaf has no child. An internal node has at least one child. The edge is the connection between two nodes. So we have here between the node 2 and 7 an edge. And what is a path? Well, it's a sequence of nodes and edges that connect a node with an ancestor. So here we have 2, 7, 6, 5, a path that goes like this. Typical operations that you do with the tree abstract data type are: you insert a node on a position on the tree, you remove a node, you prune a node, that means you remove all the node and all its descendants, all its children and their children, and so on, like really cutting up this, you know, branch over here, so this edge, and everything here would be gone when you prune it. Traversing means you want to iterate through the nodes, potentially executing a function on each node, and lastly you want to search for a key with a given value inside our tree. There are many more operations possible with the tree. Here just a typical set. So a tree has a lot of more terminology compared to lists and queues, as you may have already figured, because that is already clear when you look at this hierarchical composition. It needs a bit more clarity in terms of organization. So what is a neighbor? First of all, well, a neighbor is a parent or child, it's because they are connected by an edge. A sibling are the nodes with the same parent. So in this case, 5 and 11, they are siblings because they have the same parent node 6. The degree is the number of children a node has. So this node here has a degree of 2. And a descendant or subchild is a node that is reachable from a specific parent. So here, from this parent 7, we can reach node 5 and 11, so they are both descendants. And 6 is also a descendant of 7, by the way. An ancestor is the opposite direction, so from 5, that is a node reachable towards the root. So 5 has an ancestor 6, 7, and 2. And node 2 is, of course, the ancestor of all nodes because it is our root. This is now our last slide of our terminology. So when we organize a tree in this way, we can say that it has a certain level or depth, which is the distance between a node and a root. So all the nodes on this level have a depth of 0 because they are basically the root. Then the next level, we have a depth of 1 because we need one step to arrive at root. Then we have a depth of 2 because we need two edges to arrive at root. So the height of a tree is the maximum number of edges between any leaf and the nodes. So let's have a look. In this case, the maximum height is 3 because we basically have a depth of 3 of the overall graph. We have a maximum degree, by the way, of 2 because some nodes have 2 children. but there is no node that has more than two children. So a perfect tree would mean that all the levels are completely filled. That is not the case, because in level 2 we see that 5 has no second child, so there is one node missing. That means it's not a perfect tree. A balanced tree means the depth of the leaves in all subtrees are similar, which is basically a perfect tree, but it means on the last level you may have some items missing. This is not a balanced tree either, because again we miss here one node over here. The complete tree is similar to a balanced tree, however it means that on the last level, so on our maximum depth, the keys are as much left as possible, which isn't the case in this tree either.